short little videos where I'm going to go through something that we use on the course. Today I'm going to go through our 2D game engine. So we use this on the first year of our National Extended Diploma in Games Design. It is Construct 3, which is a web-based game 2D game engine. You can absolutely use this online now for free by going to editor.construct.net, as you can see up there. You know, if you apply for the course and come onto the course, you'll get a license to use this. So there are some restrictions in how it uses the free version. So I'm just going to go through the basics of this and just introduce the software to you and show you what we use in year one of the course. So it's important to know that we don't teach computer programming on the course. So we don't teach any languages like that. And so all the games that we make need to be done through some sort of visual programming language, and Construct is really good for this. So the reason we use this in the first year is if you've never done anything before like this, then it's pretty easy to make the game do something that you want it to do. Okay, so just going around the screen here, what we're looking at the moment, I'm using a prototype for a platform game here. So this is the very basics, as you can see, of a platform game. This is, even though it's nice brightly coloured, it's what we might call a grey boxing prototype, because there's no graphics in here. We're just using boxes to kind of box out what the level will look like. I use this to teach how to make a platform game. So we've got the player, which is the red box there. We've got the enemies, which are the green boxes. We've got collectibles represented by the yellow ones, and these orange things here, the player won't see those. They're there to make sure the enemies just go back and forth on these platforms. So very, very rudimentary artificial intelligence. We have a counter for how many collectibles, or in this case coins, the player will collect, and we've got the player will be able to jump on these enemies, and it all, this is more for the designer than the player. This would be removed when the game is produced. This is a counter just to make sure that we understand how many have been killed. I'll just show you how this works. And I think I've actually designed this for a controller. So you can go backwards and forwards, and you'll be able to jump on there. I've forgotten to plug my controller in at the moment. So, but you can see them, how they're moving backwards and forwards. You'll be able to jump on those and collect those. You can see we've collected two already. So by pressing the play button up here, we can see the game running and we can preview it. Okay, so quick run through. What you're looking at is the layout screen. And this is where, you know, you can move things around on screen. You can have your player start wherever you want them to start and move stuff around. As you can see, when I click on something, this changes on the left-hand side. So this is what we call the properties palette. So every little thing that I can click on has its own set of properties, and that's where you can change colors and positions, add behaviors. So there's a behavior palette here that gives us a bunch of pre-programmed things, so making something solid or enabling something to be jumped through. Control mechanisms here, so that we actually have a platform control mechanism, so you don't have to program that manually. Same with kind of a tank game, a direction, bullet, a lot of things get bullet. The enemies here have bullets on here. And so that's how you'll add the behaviors there. We have an area for instance variables. So that's something that we utilize to use health or gold or other things. They can have instance variables there. So we have a bunch of different things that we can utilize. On the right hand side, we've got the project, so all of the different objects and things we use in the game will be used in here. And down below, we've got layers. Now, where the programming actually comes in is on the event sheet here. This is where all the logic for the game is put. Now, as you can see, just running down a few of these, what we basically have is on the left-hand side here is events. So this is usually input from the player, or when something collides with something else, or a check of some sort. So for instance, you can see when the A button is clicked on the keyboard, that's going to make the player go left. When the player collides with the enemy, these things will happen. So the enemy is going to get destroyed. So this is when the player actually jumps on the enemy. That's what these things mean here. The enemy is going to get destroyed. We're going to add one to the enemy's killed variable, and we're going to make this bit makes the player jump up a tiny little bit. We have various other things, buttons being clicked and stuff, but basically the logic for the game gets built up, and this is what we mean by visual coding. And we click events, we decide what the thing is going to that you're affecting, what is this event concerned with. So let's say the player. And then there's loads of different things that we can say, well, what's happening to the player? What are we checking for? Or what is he colliding with? All that sort of stuff. And it's all done through these. So let's say the player, when the player is jumping. So when the player is jumping, what's going to happen? And we can decide what's going to happen. So that's how we add logic to the game. And so the students will get to bring in their own graphics. So if we go back to the level, if we want to add a graphic, we can double click on here and add different things. So we can add a sprite, or we can add various different things on here. So let's say we add a sprite, we can add control mechanisms. Let's call this sprite, I don't know, sign. Oh, which I've apparently already used. Let's say sign start for that. Click insert, and there we'll get a visual editor. So we click where we want the sign to be. It doesn't really matter, and it's a good idea to kind of click outside this so you're not accidentally clicking on something. That brings up a visual editor, and it's a very basic visual editor. So we can say, okay, well, let's just put in a placeholder for now. So let's color this a different color. We haven't had blue on, I don't think, or have we? Yeah, the platforms are blue. So let's say pinky color. And there's our sign. We can resize that. And we can place that in. And then when we come to put a graphic in, we can double click on it and we can actually open up our own graphic from here and put the graphic in. This will allow you to do animations as well, dictate the speed, we'll put the different frames at the bottom here so we can bring our own animations in. There are other functions like tile maps we can bring in. That's slightly more advanced, so you don't have to do all these individual graphics yourself. You can bring tiles in. So that's construct in a nutshell. There is more, a little bit more to it, but on the course, this is what you'll spend the first year of the course learning. We generally do a platform game like this. We do a shoot 'em up game of shmup, whoops, and we do we'll use it to do the FMP. We start off to learn how to use this. I'll start off by teaching people how to make Pong, which is one of the simplest games around, but It enables everybody to really learn how to use it. Like I said, if you want to start having to play with it yourself, then if you just go to editor.construct.net, create yourself a login, which will be a free login for now, but you'll have more than enough. There's tutorials there to help you and guides and manuals and things. Okay. So, hope this has informed you a little bit more about what we do on the course. I'll be doing another one of these videos with our 3D game engine. We use Unity in the second year, which is a little bit more complicated, of course, but we find that they've got nice progression from Construct 3. All right, hope you found this informative, and I'll see you on another video.